Hello, we are going to make a cube. Inflate 18 balloons, leaving about 7-inch flat tails. The cube has 6 sides. We are going to use 6 balloons to make every 2 sides of the cube. Let's make 3 pairs of balloons by tying ends of 2 balloons in 1 knot. We are going to twist all bubbles about the same 1-inch size. We use each balloon to twist 12 bubbles, so we twist 36 bubbles to make each side of the cube. It takes total of 216 bubbles to make this cube, and it would take more than 20 minutes to make it. Take 2 pairs of balloons and twist the first bubble in each pair. Lock the free ends of the first bubbles in one lock twist. Take the third pair, twist the first bubble in the third pair of balloons, go back to the second pair, twist another first bubble in the second pair, lock the free ends of the first bubbles in one lock twist. Now, let's take a balloon on the left side and twist a chain of first 2 bubbles. Take the next balloon, the second on the left, and twist the second bubble. Lock the free ends of the second bubbles in one lock twist. Twist the second bubbles of the 2 balloons in the middle. Lock the free ends of the second bubbles in one lock twist. Twist the second bubble of the next to your right balloon. Twist a chain of first 2 bubbles of the last right balloon. Lock the free ends of the second bubbles in one lock twist. We have made the first 2 rows of the square. We also have made a pattern. We are going to follow this pattern to make the rest of the sculpture. We have to twist total of 6 rows to make one square piece. Basically, we are going to do the same thing over and over. So, I am playing this part of the video clip on a higher speed. You don't have to rush, take your time. This instruction is a continuation of a previously published instruction Fabric 2, Cake 2, Crown 2. We made a square piece of fabric, 6x6 bubbles, in a previous instruction, and we use it to make a cake. Today we are doing the same square piece to make a cube. If you find it hard to follow me here with the first 6 balloons, then you definitely have to check previously mentioned instruction Fabric 2, Cake 2, Crown 2, where I use 6 different color balloons to make the square. I think a cube is a very basic sculpture. Quite often it is the simplest part or a base to make more complicated sculptures. We can use it as an example of what and how we can do. Okay, here we made the first square or the first side of the cube. 6 balloons, 6 bubbles in one row, 6 rows. Now we're going to twist 6 more rows to make the second side of the square. We work in the same fashion until we make the 12th row. Then we cut off the rest of the balloons and tie off the ends. You can use scissors to cut off the rest of the balloons or do it with your fingers, it's all up to you. We can use different color balloons to make color patterns. It makes our sculpture more attractive. Okay, here we just made 2 sides of the cube. Let's make the first corner of the cube. I attach the next, the green pair of balloons, to the edge of the first blue side between the 5th and the 6th rows. Twist the first green bubble. Lock the free end of the first green bubble between the next 2 blue rows, the 7th and the 8th rows. Attach the second green pair of balloons to the edge of the first blue side between the 3rd and the 4th row. It's all the same as we did at the very beginning. We twist first bubbles and then we lock free ends of the first bubbles in one lock twist. Now we attach the third green pair to the edge of the first blue side between the first and the second row. And once again, twist the first bubbles and lock the three ends in one lock twist. Take the balloon on your left, twist a chain of the first two bubbles, take the next balloon and twist the second bubble, lock the three ends of the second bubbles in one lock twist. Take the two balloons in the middle and twist the second bubbles, lock the three ends of the second bubbles in one lock twist. Take the next two green balloons and twist the second bubbles, lock the three ends of the second bubbles in one lock twist. We made the first two rows of the third side of the cube. It's all the same pattern, we are following it. The only one obvious difference is we have to attach the right green balloon to the blue side of the cube. That's all. Alright, the next part of the video clip I'm going to play on higher speed again. We just have to follow the pattern to make total of 12 rows. This way we will make two green sides connected to the first two blue sides of the cube. So far we have made three sides of the cube, and now we are making the second corner of the cube. You can see it yourself. It is a very simple sculpture, and it is kind of boring to make it. Yes, it takes 20-30 minutes to make it, and you will have real fun playing with this cube once you make it. You can use this cube to play soccer or basketball. One more thing about the size of the cube. In this example we use 6 balloons to make the square sides 6 bubbles by 6 bubbles. You should have no problem to make it with any even number of balloons. Now let's get back to our sculpture. Here we made the second green side. Now we just cut off the rest of the balloons and tie off the ends. So far we have made 4 sides of the cube. Let's fix it a bit. It looks like we made a seat for armchair. There are only 2 sides where we can attach this next set of balloons. Okay, let's attach the new set of balloons to the back of the seat. I will use 6 pink balloons to make the last 2 sides of the cube. We attach balloons and work in the same fashion as we did before. I start from the corner, attach the middle pair of pink balloons. If you manage to get to this part of the cube, then I'm sure you could make the rest of the cube without anyone's help. Just remember to connect the new pink sides as you're making them to the cube, right? Here I'm fixing the corner of the cube. And now we're going to make the second pink row. We're following the same pattern. In this example, I use 6 balloons of one color to make each 2 sides of the cube. It is a very simple color pattern. And hey, I do like simplicity. However, you should not limit yourself to simple color patterns only. Once we finish this cube, I will show you more examples of different color patterns. Hopefully, it may twist your mind even more in the use of colors in your artworks. Okay, here we're almost done with the first pink side. Getting now to the last 6 sides of the cube. I always try to use the least possible number of balloons to make all my sculptures. So here couple words just for the records. we can use a total of 12 balloons, not 18, to make the same coupe as we're making right now. It comes, of course, in a bit smaller size. It is very simple to make. Just use 6 balloons to make 3 sides of the cube, not 2 sides, as we do in this example. The big difference in number of balloons means less time to make the sculpture. That is what really counts. I cannot be wrong about that. Okay, we made the last side of the cube, cut off the rest of the balloons, and tie off the ends. We can use the cube as a hiding place for a little present, gifts, nothing sharp or heavy. You could place it inside of the cube right now. Tie the pink side to the green side of the cube, closing the gap. Use scissors to trim the ends of the balloons or just hide them between bubbles. Fix all bubbles in proper positions. Congratulations, we have made the cube. We can use the cube as toy furniture. It could be a table, it could be an armchair. Here's an armchair. It also could be a roof of a dollhouse of small size. Do I have any toys around here? Yes, lucky me. Here's a Mr. Shrek in armchair. And the chair is more like a recliner. You got the idea. Now let's see different color patterns. Here I use set of 6 balloons of one color. On this side I use set of 6 balloons, 3 colors. The same thing here. Here is another cube with different colors. In previous instruction we used slightly different technique to attach the sides to the top of the cake. Let's see how it works with the cube. We are going to start by making the extra bubble. Lock both ends in one lock twist. We have to make extra bubbles around the edge of the square side of the cube. We use extra bubbles to attach sides of the cube to each other. This way the cube will have sharp pointy edges. I think the extra bubbles makes it easier to attach sides to each other. And it's definitely much easier to add new parts to the sculpture if we use extra bubbles. In this example I use 6 balloons of rainbow colors. As you can see, basically I work in the same pattern as we did in previous cube, just adding the extra bubbles at the edges. Here we made 2 first rows. It makes a lot of sense to use this technique to make more complicated sculptures. A little dollhouse is one of those sculptures that I have on my mind as an example. Well, I'm not going to do it today. It's gotta be one of the future instructions. But you should try to make it yourself. And let us know in comments how successfully it comes out. Alright, here we come closer to the last row of the first square. I think you can manage the rest of the sculpture without any trouble. Once we made 2 squares, we're going to attach all new pairs of balloons to the extra bubbles. It's simple, right? We're doing it just for fun, so why not try to make new color patterns? Make this beauty as colorful as you could. Here we made the first square. Let me fix the balloons in proper position so you can see it better. That's it. Now let's take a look at the cube after it's completely done. The extra bubbles we use here make it look more cube-like. Absolutely, the way the cube supposed to be. Here's the different color patterns I made for this cube. Rainbow. Yeah, alright. You got the idea. Have fun and happy twisting.